Hello students, so we have been discussing chapter number 11, alcohol, phenol and ether. Till now we have discussed IUPAC nomenclature, classification of alcohol, preparation of alcohol and preparation of phenol. Today we are going to discuss new topic, and that is physical properties of alcohol and phenol. Physical properties. Okay. Now, we are writing alcohol like this, ROH, and we are writing phenol like this. Okay, this is phenol, or we can also write phenol like this, AROH. ER means aromatic. So, the physical properties of alcohol and phenol is because of this OH group, right? That means alkyl group and aryl group doesn't play that important role in physical properties. The physical properties of alcohol and phenol is mainly because of this OH group, which means OH groups play an important role for the physical properties. Okay, first physical property is boiling point. Boiling point. Okay, now please remember this topic for all other compounds or for other aldehyde and ketone groups also. So, as carbon number increases, boiling point increases, which means we have got CH3OH methanol, ethanol, propanol. So, boiling point of propanol is more than boiling point of ethanol, and boiling point of ethanol is more than boiling point of methanol, which means that as carbon number increases, boiling point increases. So I am writing BP. BP means boiling point. So as carbon number increases, boiling point increases. Okay, the reason is as carbon number increases, there will be more van der Waals interaction, there will be more van der Waals force. So we can say that compared to methanol, ethanol has got more van der Waals force. Compared to ethanol, propanol has got more van der Waals force. And as van der Waals force increases, boiling point increases. Okay, first point. Second point, suppose CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2OH, this is butanol. If we write like this, CH3, CH2OH, okay, same number of carbon, same number of hydrogen, right? But here, this is straight chain, here branch has come. So if we compare boiling point of this compound, these are isomers, they have got same molecular formula, but they have got different structure. So if you are asked to comment on boiling point of this compound, boiling point of this butanol will be more compared to this. This is known as 2-methylpropanemanol. So you can ask, sir, why there is difference in boiling point of these compounds? They have got the same molecular formula. The answer is, here state chain is there, but here branch has come, and because of branch, you can see that it has got more surface area, it has got less surface area, and as branch increases, there will be less surface area, and because of less surface area, there will be less van der Waals interaction. So here van der Waals interaction is more. This butanol can have van der Waals interaction with butanol, so more surface area is there. This 2-methylpropanemanol has got less surface area, so it has got less van der Waals interaction. So as we can say that as branch increases, there will be less van der Waals interaction and there will be less boiling point. So branch has got effect on physical properties. Branch increases, boiling point decreases. So first point is, as carbon number increases, boiling point increases, but as branch increases, boiling point decreases. Okay, so this is the main factor. Now, third factor. Third factor is based on hydrogen bonding. Okay. Okay. Now let us understand how hydrogen bond is formed in alcohol. So this is alcohol. Oxygen has got more electronegativity, so negative charge is there. Positive charge is on hydrogen. Another alcohol we can write like this: ROH. Plus charge here, minus charge here. So there will be attraction between oxygen and hydrogen, and that particular attraction is known as hydrogen bond. So there is a hydrogen bond between two alcohol molecules. Same way, if we write phenol like this, so this is phenol. H will be having positive charge, oxygen will be having negative charge. Another phenol molecule. Right, we can write like this. So there will be attraction between hydrogen and oxygen. So this is attraction, and that particular attraction is known as hydrogen bond. So there is hydrogen bond between two alcohol or two phenol molecules. So moral of the story is, there is presence of hydrogen bond between two alcohol molecules or between two phenol molecules, or between alcohol and phenol molecules, okay? And because of that, there is difference in boiling point. So if we take same molecular weight compounds like propane, methoxymethane and ethanol will have more boiling point. So we are writing like this: CH3CH2OH. This is ethanol. This is methoxymethane. This is ethanol. This is methoxymethane. And third one is propane. So this is propane. Okay. Now these three has got almost same molecular weight. There is not much difference in molecular weight. Molecular weight of ethanol is 46, molecular weight of methoxymethane is 46, and molecular weight of propane is 44. So there is not much difference in case of molecular weight, although they have got different boiling point. The boiling point of propane is 231 Kelvin. The boiling point of methoxymethane is 248 Kelvin. And the boiling point of ethanol is 351 Kelvin. Now you can ask question, sir, if they have got same molecular weight, then why such difference in boiling point is observed? Why is there is difference in boiling point? So the answer is because of hydrogen bond. Ethanol has got more tendency to form hydrogen bond. How this is going to form hydrogen bond like this, okay? Compared to ethanol, propane cannot form hydrogen bond, and there is less tendency to form hydrogen bond for ether. So this is ultimately ether, right? CH3OCH3, that is ether. So ether has got less tendency to form hydrogen bond. Propane cannot at all form hydrogen bond, whereas ethanol can form hydrogen bonds. So please remember this statement for MCQs only. If compound can have tendency to form hydrogen bond, it will have more boiling point. More hydrogen bond, more boiling point. So ethanol has got a more tendency to form hydrogen bond, so it is having more boiling point. And the difference in boiling point, look at this. It has got 231 Kelvin and it has got 351 Kelvin. More difference in boiling point, although they have got same molecular weight. So the compound which has got same molecular weight, but there is difference in boiling point because of hydrogen bond only. So hydrogen bond makes difference in case of boiling point. Next physical property is solubility. Okay. सॉल्युबिलिटी. सो नेक्स्ट फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टी इज सॉल्युबिलिटी. अल्कोहल इज सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. द रीजन इज दिस इज अल्कोहल, इट इज पोलर इन नेचर, एंड वाटर इट इज ऑल्सो पोलर इन नेचर. ऑक्सीजन विल हैव नेगेटिव चार्ज, हाइड्रोजन विल हैव पॉजिटिव चार्ज, एंड देयर इज हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड बिटवीन अल्कोहल एंड वाटर. एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड अल्कोहल इज सॉल्युबल इन वाटर. बट एज कार्बन नंबर इंक्रीजेस, एज अल्काइल चेन इंक्रीजेस, देयर विल बी लेस सॉल्युबिलिटी ऑफ अल्कोहल इन वाटर. विच मीन्स दैट इफ यू कंपेयर मिथेनॉल, इथेनॉल एंड प्रोपेनॉल इन टर्म्स ऑफ सॉल्युबिलिटी, मिथेनॉल विल हैव हायर सॉल्युबिलिटी कंपेयर टू इथेनॉल, एंड इथेनॉल विल हैव हायर सॉल्युबिलिटी कंपेयर टू प्रोपेनॉल. द रीजन इज दे ऑल कैन फॉर्म हाइड्रोजन बॉन्ड, राइट. सो अल्कोहल इज सॉल्युबल इन वाटर, बट इट हैज गॉट वन कार्बन ओनली, इट हैज गॉट टू कार्बन, इट हैज गॉट थ्री कार्बन. एज कार्बन नंबर इंक्रीजेस, एज अल्काइल चेन इंक्रीजेस, देयर विल बी मोर नॉन पोलर ग्रुप. सो दिस इज नॉन पोलर ग्रुप. सो नॉन पोलर चेन इज गेटिंग इंक्रीज, एंड आवर सॉल्वेंट वाटर इज पोलर. सो एज नॉन पोलर ग्रुप इज इंक्रीज्ड, एज द चेन इंक्रीजेस, द सॉल्युबिलिटी डिक्रीजेस. सो इन जनरल अल्कोहल इज सॉल्युबल इन वाटर, बट एज कार्बन नंबर इंक्रीजेस, और वी कैन से दैट अल्काइल चेन इंक्रीजेस, सॉल्युबिलिटी विल डिक्रीज. सो अल्कोहल इज सॉल्युबल इन वाटर, बट एज कार्बन नंबर इंक्रीजेस, सॉल्युबिलिटी विल डिक्रीज. ओके, हेलो स्टूडेंट्स. सो वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर 11, अल्कोहल, फिनॉल एंड ईथर. इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैड डिस्कस अबाउट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अल्कोहल. ओके, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ फिनॉल एंड द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फिनॉल. यू मस्ट बी नोइंग OH ग्रुप ऑन द बेंजीन रिंग. सो दिस इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फिनॉल. फिनॉल इज ऑल्सो नोन एज कार्बोलिक एसिड. फिनॉल इज ऑल्सो नोन एज कार्बोलिक एसिड. अर्लियर डेज फिनॉल यूज टू बी सिंथेसाइज फ्रॉम कोल टार. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट अर्लियर डेज, बट नाउ डेज फिनॉल इज सिंथेसाइज कमर्शियली फ्रॉम वेरियस रिएजेंट्स, राइट. सो टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रिपरेशन ऑफ फिनॉल फ्रॉम वेरियस बेंजीन डेरिवेटिव्स, और वी कैन से वेरियस हेलोएरिन्स. ओके, सो फर्स्ट प्रिपरेशन इज प्रिपरेशन फ्रॉम हेलोएरिन. प्रिपरेशन फ्रॉम हेलोएरिन्स. ओके, सो व्हाट इज हेलोएरिन? हेलोएरिन्स आर एरोमेटिक रिंग कंटेनिंग हेलोजेंस. सो वी हैव गॉट क्लोरोबेंजीन. So this is chlorobenzene. Chlorobenzene reacts with NaOH. Temperature range is 623 Kelvin and 320 atmospheric pressure. Now in your textbook there is correction. In your written part, in your textbook, in theory they have written 320 atmospheric pressure. And in equation they have written 300 atmospheric pressure. So please correct this. Okay, so chlorobenzene reacts with NaOH. Temperature is 623 Kelvin. Pressure is 320 atmospheric pressure. Okay, it will form sodium phenoxide. So how sodium phenoxide is going to form? H plus from NaOH, Cl minus from HCl, or from chlorobenzene, it will form HCl. So HCl is removed. H plus from here and Cl minus from here, it will form HCl. Now what is left? So ONA is left. So ONA will come here. दिस इज नोन एज सोडियम फिनोक्साइड. दिस इज सोडियम, एन ए इज सोडियम एंड दिस इज इथर. ओ ग्रुप इज देयर, सो दिस इज इथर. सो दिस फिनाइल रिंग प्लस इथर, दिस इज नोन एज फिनोक्साइड. दिस पार्ट इज नोन एज फिनोक्साइड. सो दिस इज सोडियम फिनोक्साइड. सो क्लोरोबेंजीन रिएक्ट्स विथ NaOH एंड इट विल फॉर्म सोडियम फिनोक्साइड. सो दिस इज सोडियम फिनोक्साइड. ओके, नाउ सोडियम फिनोक्साइड रिएक्ट्स विथ एनी एसिड. वी कैन राइट HCl और वी कैन राइट एनीथिंग, राइट, एनी एसिड एंड इट विल फॉर्म OH, इट विल फॉर्म फिनॉल. सो फिनॉल इज फॉर्म Na plus from this sodium phenoxide, Cl minus from this HCl, it will form NaCl. O and H will combine and it will form OH. So this is phenol. Okay, again. So chlorobenzene reacts with NaOH. Temperature range is 623 Kelvin. Pressure is 320 atmosphere. It will form sodium phenoxide. By the acidification of sodium phenoxide, I mean, if we react sodium phenoxide with acid, we will get phenol. So this is the first preparation of phenol from haloarene. Second preparation is from benzene sulfonic acid. From benzene sulfonic acid. Okay. Second preparation of phenol is from benzene sulfonic acid. And for that, we have got benzene over here. So this is benzene. If benzene reacts with oleum, we have already discussed about oleum. Oleum is the highly concentrated form of sulfuric acid. So benzene reacts with sulfuric acid, that is sulfonation of benzene. We have discussed in standard 11, that is sulfonation of benzene. We'll get benzene sulfonic acid. So this is benzene sulfonic acid. This is benzene sulfonic acid. Now benzene sulfonic acid reacts with NaOH and it will form sodium phenoxide. Reaction of benzene sulfonic acid with NaOH, it will form sodium phenoxide plus H2SO4. We can see that H plus from here and SO3H from here, it will form H2SO4. What is left? ON is left, so it will form sodium phenoxide. And again, acidification of sodium phenoxide, so we can write H plus or HCl here, it will form phenol. So we'll get phenol here. Again, benzene reacts with oleum. Oleum is highly concentrated form of sulfuric acid. So we are reacting benzene with sulfuric acid. So this is sulfonation reaction. So benzene plus sulfuric acid or benzene plus sodium, it will form benzene sulfonic acid. So this is benzene sulfonic acid. Benzene sulfonic acid reacts with NaOH and it will form sodium phenoxide. And by the acidification of sodium phenoxide, we will get phenol. So this is phenol. So this is the second reaction for the preparation of phenol. Now we are going to discuss third reaction. Okay. Third reaction of phenol. So third preparation of phenol is from aniline. In chapter 10, we have discussed about Sandmeyer reaction. Do you remember this reaction? Sandmeyer reaction. Aniline reacts with nitrous acid, right? It will form benzene diazonobutyrate. Do you remember this reaction? Okay, same reaction is there from aniline. Aniline is benzene and NH2 is there. NH2 is one benzene ring, is known as aniline. So this is aniline. Okay, aniline reacts with nitrous acid. And nitrous acid, we always write Na2 plus HCl. We can directly write HNO2, but More specifically, we can write any N2 plus HCl. In textbook, they have written only one HCl, but I have already discussed that there will be two HCl, right? So this is combination of any NO2 plus 2 HCl, it will form nitrous acid. Temperature range is 273 to 278 Kelvin. It will form. I am not discussing this reaction in detail because we have already discussed this reaction in chapter number 10. So aniline reacts with nitrous acid, same way reaction. It will form benzene diazone chloride. So I am writing benzene diazone chloride like this. BDC. Benzene diazone chloride. This is benzene. This is diazone chloride and this is chloride. So it will form benzene diazone chloride. Byproducts I am not writing because we have already discussed, right? So main product I am writing benzene diazone chloride. Now benzene diazone chloride reacts with water. More specifically, we can say that warm water. So it will react with water. And I have already discussed this. Whenever we write reaction of water, we need to write in the form of H plus and OH minus. We always divide water molecules in H plus and OH minus. Okay. Now this thing I have already discussed. This diazo group will be released in the form of N2. So N2 is released. This H plus and this Cl minus will form HCl. So HCl is also formed. Again, diazo group. In most of the reaction, diazo group will be released in the form of N2, nitrogen. Now, what is left? So H plus from acid, H plus from H2O, and Cl minus from this BDC, it will form HCl, acid. Now, what is left? OH minus and benzene is left. So it will form phenol. So this is phenol. Again, aniline reacts with nitrous acid. Nitrous acid is combination of NaNO2 plus HCl. Temperature range is around 273. We will get benzene diazonium chloride. Benzene diazonium chloride reacts with water. We need to warm this water and we will get water is divided into H plus and OH minus. H plus will get with Cl minus, it will form HCl. Diazo group is always released in the form of N2. What is left? So here benzene is left and here OH minus is left. It will form phenol. So this is phenol. Okay. Last reaction for the preparation of phenol, that is from cumene. From cumene. Now you must be wondering about what is cumene. So cumene is isopropyl benzene. This is benzene. Isopropyl benzene. So isopropyl benzene is like this. This is isopropyl benzene, or we can say that this is cumene. Structure of cumene is isopropyl plus benzene. This is isopropyl benzene. It is also known as cumene. Cumene is oxidized, which means it reacts with oxygen. So if isopropyl benzene or cumene reacts with oxygen, it will form hydroperoxide. So it will form cumene hydroperoxide. Now, what is the structure of cumene hydroperoxide? So oxygen is added. So oxygen is added over here. So we can write oxygen like this. Okay? And CH3 is. So this is cumene hydroperoxide. Why it is known as hydroperoxide? We have discussed in standard 11. When there is more oxygen present in any compound, right? That is known as hydroperoxide. So oxygen is added over here. So this is known as cumene hydroperoxide. So this is cumene hydroperoxide. Okay. This is cumene. If more oxygen is there, that is known as cumene hydroperoxide. And please remember, oxygen is added between carbon and hydrogen. So we are getting intermediate product cumene hydroperoxide. Now, this cumene hydroperoxide will react with dilute acid. So we are writing H plus. H plus indicates the presence of acid. And I am saying dilute acid, so I am also writing H2O. So this suggests that acid is diluted form. Acid is in diluted form. So H plus indicates acid and H2 indicates diluted form. Right? That means H plus, that means acid is diluted in water. Now, if we react cumene hydroperoxide with acid, it will break this bond. This bond is broken. And what is left? CH3COCH3. So one product is CH3COCH3, that is known as acetone. So this is acetone. So CH3COCH3 is formed as a byproduct. Right? What is that? Benzene plus OH. So it will form phenol. So our main product is phenol. So we are also getting phenol. Now we are getting acetone as a byproduct. So whenever we want to form phenol along with acetone, this reaction is helpful. Again, our last reaction for the preparation of phenol is from cumene. Cumene is isopropyl benzene. This is isopropyl and this is benzene. Its common name is cumene. It is oxidized, which means that it reacts with oxygen. So we have added oxygen here between carbon and hydrogen. So we will get cumene hydroperoxide. Hydroperoxide means addition of oxygen. This cumene hydroperoxide will react with dilute acid. So we have written H plus H2O. It will break this bond and it will form CH3COCH3, which is known as acetone, and it will form our main product, that is benzene plus OH, that is phenol. So we are getting phenol. So we have discussed preparation of phenol, right? First is from chlorobenzene, second from benzene sulfonic acid, third from aniline, and fourth from cumene. So please remember this reaction. Okay, one more thing that is not discussed in textbook. The preparation of phenol from chlorobenzene is important reaction. Okay, and from cumene is also important reaction. So you need to focus on this reaction from chlorobenzene and from cumene. In many exams they have asked preparation of phenol from chlorobenzene and cumene. Okay.